Food, as well as it has medicinal value, it has anti-diabetic, anti-cancerous, anti-hypertension. So, but the farmers in Guriz, when we interacted with them, we found out that now they are not cultivating it because they are saying we are easily getting the flour of wheat and other, like we are getting rice and other things easily from the government store. And this cultivating this buckwheat, it needs a lot of efforts. So we are now in process of awareing them. We are doing a type of awareness program, extension work, where we aware them its importance, its market value, and we are now in process of linking some food processing companies with them so that they will cultivate and they can get the market for that cultivation. And we have already profiled that for these components we call as the metabolites, like rutin, it has anti-cancerous, anti-diabetic properties. So we have profiled, we have now, we know which one. We have collected 170 different types from whole the J&K and Ladakh. We know now which one type is having high that rutin content or high mineral content or high protein content. The protein in that, it is the best quality protein. It is free of gluten. Because gluten, many people have allergic to gluten. So it is the best flour we are getting from that. So we have now lines. We know which line is having high nutritional, high nutraceutical component. We are going to multiply it. And we are also side by side, because my expertise is molecular biology, we are identified genes for all these so that through breeding, assisted breeding, we can develop the high yielding and having the high nutraceutical component.
So traditional name of buck?
Coming back to varieties of rice, are you working on preserving this mushkbazi only, or there are other varieties like nonubio, like gulzak? Are you working on that also? Not?
To be very frank, I am not rice expert, but what I know, there are some revival programs have university has started, like mushkbazi, now zag and some other. Zag is also high in iron. So university is taking up these these things, so that these land races, they will be revived because they have high nutrition or some other qualities.
So these are also aromatic varieties.
They are also aromatic varieties, and also they have high market value. So, but the problem is, again, the yield is less. So it needs some efforts by the scientific community. We have a separate rice research center at Khudbani. So I think they are working.
Sir, perhaps you talked about the buck. What is this traditional name?
It is called as Trumb.
Trumb. Yes, sir.
Mr. Mustaq Ahmed, the Honorable Vice Chancellor of this university. Thank you, sir. As all of us are well aware of the 17 Sustainable Development Goals of the United Nations, and SDG 16 is peace, justice, and strong institutions. That is to promote peaceful and inclusive societies for sustainable development. Inclusive knowledge societies are the way forward, as they build on some of human ingenuity, technical innovation, and power of information and knowledge. These inclusive knowledge societies have the potential to achieve lasting positive impacts on education, economic prosperity, social inclusion, and environmental protection.
Yeah, around some recent varieties and some sustainable varieties. Right. So we didn't, what did we collect? We sequenced the whole transcriptome, that is the express part of the genome. So once we did that, then we compared them. And seek scab resistance, which gene is not in there. So I told you that we identified 40 genes. So right now we are cloning. So there were some lags between in the last year and due to COVID.
Dr. Sam, apna number bata dijiye aap.
The committee, we are allowed to now do transgenic research, so that's good. So inshallah we'll be cloning for, it takes like 2 to 3 years to have a full
clone.
Yeah, inshallah, you're welcome.
Exactly.
So then if DBT allows us, we can kind of give this material out, and you have, it's 9797
43 9263. I welcome you all to Genome Engineering and Plant Genetics, Social Biotechnology, Societal Biotechnology Lab. My name is Dr. Amjad Husseini, and I am working as Senior Assistant Professor here. And briefly, I will explain what we have been doing. I was earlier posted at Sher Kashmir University at a station in Khudbani, where we did rice programs. So I was handling the rice germplasm program there. And while coming to this place, I took off, you know, the work which we had left there. And we had kept it like, it is very important to document the germplasm which you have. And not only document, you have to have a molecular characterization of that as well. If you have to defend the varieties, if you have to defend the local germplasm, in case of biopiracy, you have to have a molecular profile of that, right? So the first program which we conducted was to
project on drug discovery against prostate cancer. So I appreciate if you come the next target to start from the
scented and some of the pigmented rice genotypes. Pigmented means the zag. Purple rice and black rice, we had some accessions, plus we had the zag types from various places. Then mushkbuji and kamak. This was also the scented, the speciality rices. So what we did, this was the first student who did this program, who did her MSc research, and we were able to, the hypothesis was that we would be getting a lot of duplications and there will not be much of the diversity. But however, we could find using even just two dozen markers, SSR based markers, we could find that there is diversity. Still there is diversity. So that is published, that is published research in open access, you can see it. And the primary reason for this is perhaps because of the hill ecology. So one is the documentation part. So we had started that program, purification of mushkbuji, about which Dr. Sajjad may have already explained to you a little bit. We had done that purification there, and then we did this part here. So apart from that, there is one more issue, which is the climate change, which you know, like, you know, nowadays, when you see there is abrupt drop in temperature, abrupt rising temperature, at the different growth stages of the plant.
Yes, sir.
So we had observed in Khudbani that some of the plant species, you know, there is a tremendous drop at the seedling stage, and they turns yellow, tips,
yes, sir,
go burning light. So what our next program here was that we tried to get some of the, first we screened under controlled conditions all the varieties, all the germplasm which was available to us for cold tolerance at 5 degrees Celsius temperature. Under controlled conditions. This is for the first time which SCOST has done in my lab. Then we found some of, you know, two promising genotypes which are highly cold tolerant. And we, one of the PhD students worked on transcription factors. You know, I am being directed that I should wind up quickly. Mm-hmm. So any case, winding up short.
Yes, yes, yes,
we have been able to see some of the transcription factors which are cold responsive and which are found in these cold tolerant varieties, high altitude cold tolerant varieties. So the next step in future would be to use these genes for developing, for introgressing them into the high yielding varieties which do not possess cold tolerance. So that issue we're handling. Then we had a quick program on this adulteration of saffron. It is also a major issue. And a Stanford University Professor Manu Prakash, he had an MOU with DBT, and DBT, we proposed to DBT that we are going to use this foldoscope. It's a small instrument, it's a paper microscope. Can we use it to detect fake saffron?
Okay.
Fake saffron. So we have been able to standardize a protocol, a method, wherein if you can just pass on this calendar. Calendar. Calendar, okay. I'll show you quickly. So we developed this calendar also. I had to struggle a lot, you know, to get things done. But in any case, this is saffron, okay? Mm-hmm. So here, this is foldoscope. This paper microscope. This is foldoscope.
Instrument
used.
This is a lacha type of saffron which is being used, which is generally here, you know, available in Kashmir. Then you have the processed one, which is called as the mungra. And we had procured the fake saffron. Yes. It was very difficult to get fake saffron. Nobody will give you the fake saffron. You know it yourself. So I had to, you know, use my resources and get all this. These are the photographs of the fake saffron. If you see the fake saffron, it resembles very much to the true saffron also. So what we did here, this is a concept, like, you know, in every month there is a photograph of the fake saffron, so that people get to, you know that there are different types of saffron which are being sold, but which are fake.
What's this? Look, this fake saffron actually is the other part.
Sir, it is grown. Or is it grown, sir? Here,
some other material.
You know, there are different these types. So some are artificial, some are different parts, some are co-op silk, some are, and they don't reveal you the actual thing. This is fake. Look, it looks very close. Okay. So finally, we could develop a.
Lastly, I want to ask one thing. To you, this is the biggest achievement as far as research part of the university is concerned.
Working here under so tragic, difficult conditions, and yet able to produce students who are par excellence, and getting funds, projects, and developing this lab. I have devoted, you know, money from my pocket for this.
What would be the gift from SCOS to the people of Dubai, as far as the rice is concerned?
For the gift is that we have found some of the genes which are cold tolerant responsive, which can be tested in future for developing cold tolerant rice varieties.
I will take one second. Zag is perhaps it is grown, still grown in Larno. Larno,
yes, yes,
where
yes.
You have a good unit there, high altitude, scorched. I have visited those very areas, and now it is replaced there. People are interested to grow this Zag there.
The problem with all this is with respect to educating the people.
Yes, sir.
When you see when you pass it,
yes,
through the machine,
yes,
and you get it processed,
yes, sir.
The pericarp is, yes, actually removed.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So people don't like the color of this. They need to be educated that this epicarp, this is highly nutritious.
Nutritious, yes, sir.
So earlier, pregnant women, yes, those having anemia, these people were
perhaps rich in B complex.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So these were fed with this kind of rice.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So now we have to educate people that no, you know, don't ignore it.
No,
this Zag varieties, these pigmented varieties,
yes, sir,
are better nutritionally, yes, as compared to. They have antioxidants. They have anthocyanin.
Yes, sir.
Which is higher than the normal ones.
A university concerned with the rural people, a university concerned with the problems and constraints facing agriculture and allied disciplines, can be animal husbandry, can be fishery, can be agriculture, can be forestry, and other problems associated such as tragedy reduction in the farming enterprises. Our first and foremost duty, as you are given to understand, is educating our people, capacity building. Our youngsters, giving them education with regard to their UG program, their PG program, and their research program activities and their PhD program.